Responsive sites look great and work well no matter what devices your visitors are using. In Webflow, you use breakpoints to adjust styles and layouts for different screen sizes, all within a single design. In this video, you'll learn how styles cascade across breakpoints, how to adjust layouts, how structural changes affect breakpoints, and how to test and troubleshoot. Plus, you'll get some tips for designing responsively. So let's get started. When you first build in Webflow, you're starting at the base breakpoint. That's desktop. From there, styles cascade down to tablet, mobile landscape, and mobile portrait. If you add larger breakpoints, like 1280 or 1440, styles cascade up from the desktop to those. Let's walk through an example. We'll select a heading on the canvas and set its font size to 50 pixels on desktop. Now, when we switch to tablet, the heading also shows 50 pixels. That's because it's a smaller breakpoint inheriting the style from the desktop. Now, let's change it to 40 pixels on tablet. And when we switch to mobile portrait, the heading is now 40 pixels there too, because that override cascades down. And we'll make it even smaller here. And we'll adjust the top spacing in a bit so the full heading is visible. But now, each breakpoint has its own value. 50 on desktop, 40 on tablet and mobile landscape, and 30 on mobile portrait. And notice that a blue property label means the style was set on this breakpoint, like this font size. An amber label means the style is inherited from somewhere else. We'll look at this more when we troubleshoot later. But the same thing works in reverse. Styles cascade up from the desktop to larger breakpoints. And if we set a style on the larger breakpoint, like making the font even bigger here, the style is updated on this large breakpoint, but does not affect any of the smaller breakpoints below. So to sum it up, styles, like this margin change, cascade up from the desktop to larger breakpoints and down to smaller ones, unless they're overridden, meaning you set a different value on a breakpoint, like adding more margin here on mobile portrait. Now, let's take a closer look at layout and spacing. On desktop, we've arranged our hero section with text and image side by side by setting the parent container to flex. When we switch to tablet, maybe the layout still works, but it needs more space between elements. Here, we could adjust the gap, or add more margin or padding to the elements or their parent containers. But on mobile landscape, the layout starts to feel tight. So here, we could stack the text and image vertically by adjusting the layout direction. Then, on mobile portrait, maybe we adjust the font size or spacing to keep things balanced. Grid layouts are also a very flexible option. With these, you can adjust the number of columns or rows on a breakpoint, and once again, any other properties you need to make the design work better on this breakpoint. So you can start to see how layout and spacing can work together to make responsive designs. But what about structural changes? Importantly, structural changes apply to all breakpoints. If you change how elements are ordered or where they're nested, that change will cascade to all breakpoints. And if you delete an element, even on a small breakpoint like mobile, it's gone everywhere. And if you add a new element or content, that's added to all your breakpoints. But here's a useful workaround. You can hide an element on a breakpoint by setting its display to none. For example, the background image and side-by-side image in this testimonial section might not work well on mobile without a lot of redesign. So, we could set the image wrapper to display none here on mobile landscape. That change will cascade down to mobile portrait, but the image will still show on all the other breakpoints. Okay, with all these changes we've made, let's talk about testing and troubleshooting. Use preview mode and canvas resizing to check your layout across screen sizes as you build. If something doesn't look right, like this heading size, switch to the breakpoint where the issue appears and check the style panel. Remember, a blue property label means the element's style is set directly on the current breakpoint, like this too large line height. As a fix, you could reset the style to fall back to the inherited value. An amber label means the style is inherited. You can click it to see which selector is applying the value and an icon that tells you which breakpoint it was set on. Now, we could override the size by setting a new value here on mobile. But notice, we'd be styling the combo class isDark, which is stacked on top. And that might not be what we want. As a fix, you can temporarily remove a combo or global class to style a base class, then reapply it after you've made your changes. And you could do that here or on a larger breakpoint, depending on where you want styles to cascade. The bottom line, just make sure you know which selector you're styling and on which breakpoint you're working before you make changes. Okay, let's close with a few more tips to help you design responsively from the start. First, do most of your styling on desktop and keep overrides on other breakpoints minimal and only as needed. This keeps your design consistent and easy to maintain. Next, explore variable modes to define a style that changes between breakpoints, like specifying a font size to be used on each breakpoint. So we could use the variable we just saw with modes to style the font size on a class applied to many of our headings. And when we switch between breakpoints, those values adjust automatically without needing to set styles on each one. And for our next tip, notice we use rem for that variable's font size, a relative unit. Relative units like m, rem, vw, and percent, which we could use to size these images, let elements scale more naturally. Unlike fixed units, which can lock your design into sizes that may not work for all devices. And speaking of sizes, next tip, make sure touch targets like buttons or text links are set to sizes that make them easy to tap on small screens. This is especially important for mobile users and accessibility. And last, before publishing live, publish to your staging environment. Click around and experience your site from a visitor's perspective. And better yet, interact with your design on real devices. Okay, let's recap. We covered how styles cascade across breakpoints, how to adjust layout and spacing for different screen sizes, how structural changes affect all breakpoints, how to test and troubleshoot as you build, and some practical tips to help you design responsively from the start. So, responsive design isn't just about making your site look good. It's about creating a smooth, reliable experience for all your visitors.